pure as the driven snow, when to him she was wed. Her modesty and virtue placed a high price on her head. A high price on her head. Oh, he was loud and he was proud, her chastity to tell. And families of high degree said he had married well. Said he had married well. It had not been too long a time when he from home did stray, and with no words to comfort her would spend whole nights away. Would spend whole nights away. She tossed and turned, her poor heart burned. Oh, where did I go wrong? To have a married life so brief and a maidenhood so long. And a maidenhood so long. She filled a pocket of his coat with pebbles made of coal. Time he prepared to leave, she clipped a tiny hole. She clipped a tiny hole. On silent streets with silent feet, she followed close behind. He disappeared into a room, and she could see what kind. And she could see what kind. She made her way the very next day and knocked upon that door. A voice within said, "Come on in, pray, what are you here for? Pray, what are you here for?" The women sat down face to face, the wife looked all about. "Why does my husband come to you? My dear, he rents me out. My dear, he rents me out. Oh, you ruiner of marriages, you homewrecker," she cried. "To think that while I lay alone, he stayed here at your side. He stayed here at your side. 'Tis he, not me, that broke your vows. His weakness brings him here. I do not care one whit for him. It's only a career. It's only a career. Now listen, child, and listen well. I'm not your enemy. I'm rented nights, you're bought outright, each from necessity. Each from necessity. At that, a rap upon the door, the husband, he walks in. Both wife and whore rush to the door, receive him with a grin. Receive him with a grin. Oh, tell me, is he yours tonight? Pray tell, whose turn is it? The whore said, "Sire, I'm not for hire." The wife chimed in, "I quit." The wife chimed in, "I quit." Now it's understood that a whore's no good, and a virgin bride is nice. But laws by men will favor them, so girls, you'd best think twice. So, girls, you'd best think.